divisibility check for 3 and multiples of 3. We have very wonderful shortcut for this. So in order to learn this shortcut, I have a new concept that is called as digital root or digital sum. What is digital sum? It is sum of individual digits iterated, that is nothing but repeated, until you get single digit. So you have to learn this concept, because this will find you so many shortcuts, not only for this, it is for throughout mathematics. You can find many shortcuts on this. Shortcuts. And the competitive exam, and if whenever you have objective questions for all the mathematics, you can apply this digital sum method. What is this digital? If you have a number for like this, 112, the digital sum for this, digital sum, sum digital, assume digital as a single digit. Sum, what is it? It is equal to 1 + 1 + 2. If you add it individually and you get a single digit, then it is called digital sum. What is the answer here? 1 + 1 + 2? It is 4. What happens if I have 987? Okay, what is this? 24. Okay, and as repeated until you get a single digit. So we have to repeat it again, like 2 + 4, which is equal to 6. Until you get a single digit, you have to repeat this. And this is the concept of digital sum, and it is useful in multiplications, divisions, powers of x, and many ways it is useful. So first learn this concept. Okay, next, in due course of time, I'll give you more examples of this digital sum where I am applying this digital sum. Okay, let's apply this digital sum concept when you are applying this divisibility rule for 3, 6, and 9. Okay, so in order to take divisibility rule here for any number, first find its digital sum for that number. And if digital sum value is divisible by 3, then the number, whole number, gets divisible by 3. So for example, if you have numbers like this, 9, 1, 3, what is the digital sum for here? 9 + 1, 10, 10 + 3, 13. So again, until single digit, you have to add this, it gets 4. So whether 4 gets divisible by 3 or not, no. So obviously, so 9, 1, 3 is not divisible by 3. Got it? So take one more example. 1, 2, 6. What is the digital sum for this? 1 + 2, 2 + 6. It is 9. Whether 9 gets divisible by 3 or not? Yes. So obviously it has to be this 1, 2, 6 is divisible by 3. Right? It is very simple. Now I know you will get a question. So if the number is such a large, then adding individual digits also very difficult. Yeah. I have again one more logic shortcut for this. So whenever you have 9 or sum of numbers is 9, ignore that number in your addition. Got it? Whenever there is a number 9 and sum of digits is 9 or multiple of 9, ignore those numbers, and the remaining number only you consider for this rule, this digital sum. Got it? How? If you have numbers like this, 9 + 9 + 9. So 3. So now we have 9, 9, 9, 3. As I told you, whenever you have 9, ignore this, don't count this for digital sum. So what is left now if you don't have 9, 9, 9? Only 3. If 3 is, whether 3 is divisible by 3 or not? It's divisible. Okay, over. Now, get me one more example. 7, 2, okay? 9, 1, 2. Okay? Now, as I told you, ignore 9 or sum of 2 digits, multiples of 9. So, I can ignore this. And 7 + 2 = 9. I can ignore this. Now what is left? 1 + 2, 1 + 2, 3, 3. Whether 3 gets divisible by 3 or not, it just gets divisible. So obviously this whole number is divisible by 3. Got it? So this is a special advantage of 3. So why I have to ignore 9? So 9 is very important and most powerful number in maths. And why it is powerful number in maths, I will make separate video regarding 9. So wherever 9 is there, treat it as a god, and god is invisible, so don't see 9 there. Got it? And if sum of 2 numbers is a 9, again ignore it, because that is god. wherever you heard number 9, ignore that, because that is God. God is invisible. The whole concept of this digital sum and ignoring 9. Without these two, we cannot make this shortcut very easily. So imagine you have number 9271432, and if I ask you whether this number is divisible or not, okay, normal true traditional logic of divisibility three condition is add all these numbers, and if the sum is divisible by 3, then it will be. Instead of here, by applying digital sum and ignoring 9, ignore 9, no need. 7 plus 2, 9, no need. 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 2, 9, no need. Only 1 is different and 1 is not divisible by 3. So we say that the number is not divisible by 3. Such a wonderful shortcut which you can apply in your complicated sums. Fine. Now, before going to 6, let's jump to 9. Okay? 9 can be written as 3 into 3. So it's combination of 3's. And whatever digital rule we are following here, digital sum rule, equal for 9. Okay? So, but here we have 3, 2, 3's, so we require 2 numbers. No, it's the same rule, digital sum. But one thing is, if digital sum is divisible with 9, then number is divisible by 9. Here, digital sum has to be divisible by 3. Here, digital sum has to be divisible by 9. Fine? So, if you are ignoring 9 here, then digital sum becomes 0. So, whenever you are ignoring, you will get answer 0. Whenever you are not ignoring, if it is divisible by 9, then this gets divisible by 9. Fine? Next, we will come to 6. What is 6? 2 is a 3. 2 is a 6. So, here you have to apply the rule of both 2 and 3. So it has to follow both rules, like 2 rule and 3 rule. What is 2 rule? The last digit should be even number. That is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. What is 3 rule? The digital sum has to be divisible by 3. Digital sum is divisible by 3. So if both these rules, this rule and this rule is applied, then that number gets divisible by 6. Okay? For example, here you have 2 and 6. So first rule, check whether it gets divisible by 2 or not. As it is 6 is in the digit, it gets divisible by 2. One step is over. Second step, find digital sum. What is the digital sum for this? 6 plus 2 plus 1, that is 9. 9 gets divisible by 3. So, it is divisible by both. So, then the 2 and 6 number gets divisible by 6.
Please subscribe to my channel, Connecting Minds, for more videos. And please share link with your friends.